In this video, I will be answering these questions and completing an ANOVA table for this multiple regression scenario. Here are the formulas we need for the ANOVA table. First, we have 40 observations, so n equals 40, and 5 independent variables, means k equals 5. So we have df regression k equals 5 here. And for df total, n minus 1 is 40 minus 1, which equals 39. df residual or error will be 39 minus 5, which gives 34. We're given the unexplained variation SS residual or SSE to be 93.5 here. Total variation or SS total is given as 150.3. Thus, SS regression or SSR will be SST minus SSE, which gives 56.8. Now, MS equals SS over DF. So, MSR equals 56.8 divided by 5, which gives 11.36. And MSE is 93.5 divided by 34, which gives 2.75. The F statistic is MSR over MSE, which gives 4.13. The ANOVA table is now complete. To compute the coefficient of determination, we will use SSR over SST, that is 56.8 divided by 150.3, and that gives 0.3779. That is, about 38% of the variation in the dependent variable can be explained by the variation in the independent variables. The remaining 62% is not explained by the model. Next, we can compute the adjusted R squared by using this formula. N minus 1 is 39, N minus K minus 1 is 34, and R squared is 0.3779. Substituting those in the formula gives an adjusted R squared of 0.2864. For the standard error, we can simply take the square root of the mean squared error of 2.75 here, and that gives 1.658. Finally, we conduct an overall significance test for the model at alpha equals 0.05. The null hypothesis for the test is that the regression coefficients of the 5 independent variables are all zero. That is, there is no significant relationship between the dependent variable and any of the independent variables. The alternative hypothesis would be that at least one of the coefficients is not zero. That is, at least one independent variable is linearly related to the dependent variable. The test statistic is the F-stat computed here to be 4.13. The critical F value for this test can be obtained from the F table with numerator degrees of freedom k equals 5 and the denominator n minus k minus 1 equals 34. At alpha equals 0.05, this critical value turns out to be approximately 2.5. In other words, we will reject the null hypothesis if the test statistic is greater than 2.5. Since our test statistic is greater than the critical value, we reject the null hypothesis at alpha equals 0.05. Alternatively, by using software, we can also obtain the p-value to be 0.0049. Since this p-value is less than our alpha of 0.05, we will again reject the null hypothesis using the p-value approach. In essence, both the critical value and the p-value methods should lead to the same decision. We can thus conclude that the overall model is significant or valid. That is, there is a significant relationship between the dependent variable and at least one of the independent variables. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.